2 minutes away from 8 o'clock. Here's a bold claim. You can have a happy family by Friday. Well, of course, maybe Wednesday of next week. Anyway, psychologist and author Dr. Kevin Leman says it's not all that difficult. If you just juggle the big five. Big five would be time, priorities, activities, work, and finances. And finances are such a struggle for so many families. Isn't that what causes more conflict than anything else?
Well, it does, but once you have those, what do you call them, children?
Oh, yeah. Complicating factor.
That's when things really crank up. But, you know, it's interesting. All the Have a New, I wrote Have a New Kid by Friday, Have a New Husband by Friday, all those books are scams, including this one, because you don't have to wait till Friday. In other words, in this book, Tim, I say, you know, parents, you're the parent here. Mm-hmm. Changing your words. And listen to this statement. Changing your words. The words you say to your son or your daughter can change the very trajectory or direction of that relationship. Men, you're a man, I'm a man. Mm-hmm. We hate questions from our wives. And we hate the why word. What do parents do when kids come home from school? How was your day today at school, honey?
Right.
Fine. What'd you do? Nothing. Teenager, where you been? Out. What'd you do? Nothing. Save your breath. So don't ask kids questions, okay? If you do, they'll tune you out. They'll go to their bedroom, slam and click the door, and then they'll text their buddies like a woodpecker right. That's got ADHD.
Are moms more likely to strike their children deaf? That the kids just tune out because moms tend to talk more than dads do?
Yes, women use 3.5 times the number of words that us men use in a given day. So kids play mom like a violin. And usually mom spends more time with kids, okay? Mm-hmm. So it's interesting a dad just says things once where mom has to harangue him 3 times. But part of having a happy family by Friday is having fun. You know, lighten up. When a kid slams the door, what do most parents say? Hey, don't slam the door in this house, young man. You'd be so smart, parent, just to say, excuse me, honey, I'm not sure what that slam door meant. Did that mean you're sick of living in this 4-bedroom home with all the amenities of life? Just checking. And so, this is a simple book. It's about disciplining kids to learn to be respectful of the parents' authority
right.
in the home.
You've done a lot on birth order and the differences between the firstborn, the lastborn, the one in the middle. And one of the things that you say in this book is lighten up on the firstborn. Because firstborns will frequently complain that, wait a minute, why were you so much tougher on me than you are on that one?
Listen, I don't care what he did. You are the oldest. I expect more young men or young women. So, yeah, I say lighten up on the firstborn. The firstborn doesn't have to be the garbage man forever. When that firstborn gets into more activities in school, for example, pass those activities, those jobs mm-hmm. in the home down to the kids. So the question is, are you rearing your kid in a home or hotel? In hotels, we give them room service and food service. In a home, everybody gives back to the family. Mm-hmm. So have fun in families.
You know, it's one piece of advice that I heard from you years ago, and then I started doing it, and usually I don't listen to advice, but it was a terrific piece of advice. It was not just praise your children,
yeah,
but tell them why. Not just, you're a great kid, but I really like it when you...
Thanks for doing that.
Right.
That was so helpful. So it's the words you use with your kids. That's what I call giving your kid vitamin E. And every parent in the greater Dallas area believes that praise is good for kids. You want to praise something in life, praise God. All others pay cash. Kids need encouragement. So talking to kids, tell me more about that.
Right.
Don't ask questions. And people say, well, if I didn't ask questions, my kid would never talk to me. That's not true.
Uh-huh.
Just wait. He puts that terrible music in the morning. Don't tell him to turn that off or down. Say, turn that up.
Yeah.
When a kid turns it up, say louder.
Right. What's that song about?
And get the, if you don't,
exactly.
Tim, I'm just telling you, they'll throw you a bone and they'll shut you out of your life,
yep.
Period.
Yep. Great advice, as always. A link to Dr. Lehman's website. And book number what is coming out?
Book number 50 is on its way, and 51 is done as well.
Well, right now, you can have a happy family by Friday. Then get the next book. More information and links on the Good Day tab on myfoxdfw.com. Thank you so much, as always.
Thank you, Tim.